In this context, of course, the more information we have about what's going on in the board, how the government's exploration process works, the better. But to this day, we do not have a consistent picture of how hydro model that includes cosmic exploration works. We have hydro model that includes that, but you have to adjust some parameters like the injection efficiency or whatever. And well, yeah, of course, it's always interesting to have as much information as you can. Okay. Oh, thank you. Now I'll mention my other two slides. This is 2006. This is the one that I'm working on now. And we also believe this is Tigerlake. But if you look at the steps in the thermal cycle here, this is more iron. That's not very interesting. The reason for this is that this one is such an intensity on the medium that the reverse shock has not had time to make it to the iron-rich region. So this is another independent way of showing that there's no iron in the outer layers that could not really get there. If you open up and you see a tiny little iron drop line there. But it's tiny compared to the others.
Can you give a prediction on how it
will work? Well, don't do that, yes. And I'll end with this metaphor remnant. We have looked at over the 750 kilopascal exposure with Chandra. And we believe this is a type of super remnant that's interacting with some sort of certain solid medium. So the reason that we believe it's a type of A is that there's plenty of iron in the ejecta, but no oxygen. So this is very, very preliminary because the observations were just finished. I don't really mean a type of A, that's a very good point. I mean a thermonuclear supernova. Thermonuclear didn't sit here, that's a major type of A. It's a much more complicated story. The figure out how to model that, because the physical interaction here is very simple. I uniform on a medium will not do. Just by looking at it, you see that right away. But, you know, to show me the non-thermonuclear supernova that produces lots of iron and lots of oxygen, that has to be a thermonuclear supernova. It was not as bright as Tycho, and definitely not as bright as Western Hemisphere. But Kepler is also a little more hollow, and I don't know how much of that lack of brightness comes from the existence of and how much from the fact that it's in a different location. It's pretty highly galactic latitude, so absorption should not be. I'm running way out of time, guys. Okay. Okay, so thanks for coming. The motivation